So you were just here. You just heard President Xi Jinping's speech. Anything stick out to you as, of course, against the backdrop of these trade frictions between China and the United States?
Absolutely. I thought it was a remarkable speech, not only with respect to its underlying themes and tones, but also the very explicit statements that she made that could only be construed as a direct response to statements made by the U.S. president over the last week or two.
Now, he is, of course, he didn't mention the United States or Trump by name, but he is talking about some of the frictions that are happening in geopolitics, but also in the global economy. He also made good on what we thought he was going to do and open up the market, or at least pledge to open up the market here further. There is some promise fatigue going on, though, with Chinese leaders and their promises for reform. Do you have that?
I don't. You know, Lennar International has been active in the Chinese market for almost 5 years now, which makes us the new kids on the block, I think, on a relative basis. But every single year that we've been active in China, we've seen incremental reforms, incremental openness, incremental transparency. And that's done nothing but, frankly, help our business.
How does it, though, affect your sales in the United States if there is going to be a clampdown on maybe foreigners buying Chinese buying in the United States? The Chinese also have their own restrictions, as evidenced by the larger conglomerate problems at Anbang or HNA, but also they've had some restrictions on foreigners and their forex transactions to places like the United States. How are you being impacted?
Not at all. I mean,
not at all.
Yeah, no. Fortunately, you know, the U.S. continues to be the number one destination for foreign investment in real estate globally. Nothing is changing that. President Xi talked about the expansion of property rights in China today. The U.S. obviously has well-established property rights and property law that makes investing in a U.S. home or purchasing a U.S. home or, frankly, just investing in U.S. real estate a very predictable exercise backed by the rule of law. Another comment that President Xi had today with respect to upholding the rule of law in China. All these things are positivist themes. I mean, the fundamentals of his speech today were positive with respect to global engagement, global collaboration, opening up, continuing 40 years of reforms. That's all been great for us in the last 5 or 6 years.
So you don't necessarily feel that the wave in China to crack down on irrational investments includes individuals buying homes like yours that are sold across the country?
We just haven't seen it.
Okay. What share of homes and projects are sold to foreigners, in particular Chinese?
So it's still a relatively small share in the United States. The U.S. property market is a robust property market domestically, so it doesn't rely on significant foreign involvement like some other property markets, yeah, even in this region in Asia. So it doesn't have a significant impact on the U.S. property market, but it is an incremental benefit to a company like ours that has a focus on international sales. We're the only home builder in America that has that focus, and it's still in the single digits in terms of overall impact on our sales. However, it's a welcome component because it helps us expand our reach. And anytime you have global expansion and global engagement, you find all kinds of other opportunities to enhance your business.
Now, in the pre-interview, you told me that you've gotten out of EB-5 program and purchases by the Chinese. The EB-5 program was green cards in exchange for, what, $500,000 in investment that creates 100 jobs in the United States. You're not doing these kind of programs anymore?
So we've been very successful with EB-5-related job creation programs. We've concluded our last program just recently. Our lending partner made that announcement. It was extremely successful, just as all of our programs have been. Those are utilized by us for really heavy infrastructure-style investments that do create substantial jobs. So we don't need or really seek that in our ordinary course business. For us, it was a time and point of need, and we've moved on from that.
Very quick, Chris, the U.S. property market's still going up. Property, our rates going to go up as well this year. Three more hikes.
Strong fundamentals in the U.S., rate insensitivity among foreign buyers. We're happy to be at Boao. We're happy to be in Asia.